Despite the unresolved issues at the end of Flight 8, attention now turns to the upcoming effort, Starship Flight 9. This flight will serve as a critical assessment of SpaceX's capacity to learn from previous setbacks and implement improvements, especially given the recent loss of two consecutive Starship second stages. That said, the challenges faced in previous launches have made the journey to Flight 9 much easier. In fact, the mission has already faced potential obstacles that could hinder its scheduled launch date. Let's dive deeper into today's NR Studio episode. Following the launch of Starship Flight 8, Elon Musk tweeted, "Today was a minor setback. Progress is measured in time. The next ship is expected to be ready in 4 to 6 weeks." His tweets convey a very optimistic outlook, despite the partial vehicle loss. This mentality has consistently characterized Musk and SpaceX, viewing failures as important milestones in the pursuit of innovative rocketry. If Musk's projections prove accurate, Flight 9 could begin as early as the first week of April, with a possible launch as late as mid-April. The relevant question, however, is whether Starship can meet its schedule. The most pressing challenge is the FAA investigation following the March 6, 2025, Flight 8 explosion. After Ship 34 disintegrated in midair and then crashed into the ocean, the FAA launched an investigation into the incident. Historically, these evaluations have led to subsequent launch delays. After the January 16, 2025, Flight 7 crash, the Federal Aviation Administration took about 50 days to grant a launch license for Flight 8. If a comparable timeline holds, Flight 9 will likely be significantly delayed. If the Flight 8 investigation follows a comparable timeline, approval may not be obtained until mid to late April, putting Flight 9 close to or beyond the six-week projection. Elon Musk's assertion that this is a minor setback reflects an optimistic view. However, the pace of the regulatory process often trumps SpaceX's inherent assurances. Technical readiness is another variable in the equation. Flight 9 is expected to use Ship 35, along with Booster 14, which was previously used on Flight 7, or Booster 16. SpaceX is currently conducting testing at masses. However, the new Block 2 ship design, which is intended to survive re-entry, required modifications after the loss of Ship 34. The 4 to 6 week preparation timeframe referenced by Elon Musk suggests that SpaceX is actively addressing engine or feed duct issues stemming from Flight 8. However, unforeseen challenges encountered during static fire tests or the stacking process could extend this schedule, especially if new hardware, such as an improved Raptor configuration, is included. Additionally, Flight 9 seeks to replicate the accomplishments of Flight 7 and the recovery of Flight 8's booster, while also ensuring that the spacecraft successfully reaches orbital status, a feat that has been elusive. Musk has spoken of lofty aspirations, such as catching up to the spacecraft, but the successive failures of the upper stage suggest that SpaceX may need to recalibrate its focus on improving reliability. The inclusion of each additional test objective extends the preparation time, potentially pushing the schedule into May. However, predicting what SpaceX will do next has proven to be a daunting challenge given their rapid pace of innovation. They have the ability to accelerate at any given moment, suggesting that a Starship launch that happens on schedule, as Elon Musk has anticipated, remains a plausible scenario. SpaceX's most important asset right now is its vast experience. Many of the issues observed in Flight 8 were persistent problems carried over from Flight 7, including engine leaks, an onboard fire, and a failure that ultimately resulted in loss of control of the vehicle. Indeed, the sight of charred debris and debris strewn across the terrain resonates with an unsettling sense of familiarity. The Super Heavy suffered multiple engine failures during boostback burns, culminating in the inability of one engine to reignite before landing. While these issues may seem significant, SpaceX has been diligently investigating them since Flight 7, suggesting that they are not starting over from scratch, but are instead honing solutions they have already established. As a result, the investigation into Flight 8 is anticipated to progress at a much faster pace, facilitating the implementation of important improvements with greater efficiency. The hardware for Flight 9 is currently undergoing testing at a remarkable pace. Booster 16 has successfully completed cryogenic testing at Massey and will return to the production facility for engine installation before its trip to the launch pad for static fire testing. Meanwhile, Ship 35 has successfully completed 3 cryogenic hold tests and is scheduled to return to the production facility later this week. A significant benefit in this context is that the testing schedule for Starship is not entirely dependent on the launch pad, allowing for simultaneous preparation of various components. Furthermore, the launch pad has undergone accelerated repairs following recent flights, making delays unlikely. Provided all progress is as anticipated, SpaceX could have Flight 9 ready to go in 4 to 6 weeks. Given the rapid turnaround time, they may even forego comprehensive integration testing, similar to their approach with Flight 8, in order to accelerate the schedule even further. The mission profile for Flight 9 is anticipated to remain consistent. Super Heavy is poised to make another landing attempt utilizing the Mechazilla arm. If this attempt proves successful, it would mark the third consecutive booster recovery. In parallel, Starship will prioritize improving in-space operations, including payload deployment, in-orbit engine reignition, re-entry with enhanced heat shield and engine safety, and finally, a successful ocean landing. All indications point to an imminent launch, making this a good time for speculation. I'm leaning toward a launch date of April 20th, exactly 2 years after Starship's maiden flight. We invite your thoughts. Please share your insights in the comments section below. In the face of significant challenges, SpaceX is forging ahead with the unwavering determination that has been the company's hallmark since its founding. Ever the visionary, Elon Musk has presented a bold and ambitious timeline that stretches the boundaries of perceived feasibility. However, if there is a team that has the ability to overcome such a daunting challenge, it is undoubtedly SpaceX. If Flight 9 goes as planned, the next major milestone that is just around the corner is Flight 10, an attempt that is set to witness the ambitious attempt to capture the giant Starship using the Mechazilla arm. It is a bittersweet moment for fans, as the long-awaited capture will not occur aboard Flight 9. However, the delay should not be viewed as a setback, but rather as a valuable opportunity. It gives SpaceX more time to diligently upgrade Tower B and its complex systems, thereby ensuring the remarkable and glorious success of the maiden upper stage retrieval. Despite the unexpected twists and turns that may await us, one unchangeable truth remains. With each launch, SpaceX carves out new chapters in the annals of space exploration history, and we are fortunate to witness the evolution of spaceflight unfold before our very eyes. So stay alert and don't let your eyes wander. You don't want to miss a moment of this incredible expedition. We ask for your support by subscribing, liking, and sharing so that we are more excited for the next SpaceX journey update. Before turning that momentous capture into reality, SpaceX must refine a constellation of critical systems, each of which presents a different set of challenges. At the forefront is the hazardous re-entry process, a significant hurdle in Starship's evolution. Unlike Super Heavy boosters, which undergo a relatively quick and uncomplicated descent through Earth's atmosphere after separation, Starship faces a much more difficult journey. Upon re-entry from orbit, it faces extreme temperatures and intense aerodynamic pressures that challenge the limits of engineering capabilities. To meet these challenges head-on, the heat shield system needs significant improvements. The problems encountered by the S-29 spacecraft during flight expose the inherent vulnerabilities of the current design, prompting SpaceX to explore a range of potential solutions. These could include advanced ablative materials engineered to withstand high temperatures, as well as the incorporation of flight termination systems designed to ensure safety during extreme conditions. Evidence suggests that these advances are being applied to the next generation Starship 5.2, which is already showing promise with experimental innovations such as enhanced cooling channels and reinforced metal tiles. These innovations are not static. Instead, they will continue to evolve as SpaceX gathers critical data from post-flight analysis and real-world performance, refining the design with each subsequent iteration. Another critical system under review is the flap mechanism, which serves as a fundamental element of Starship's ability to manage its descent trajectory. The V2 flaps are a significant improvement over their V1 predecessors, featuring improved design and functionality. However, they remain largely untested in the demanding environment of real-world flight conditions. SpaceX will need to carefully assess their performance on future missions, particularly during the critical re-entry phase, where heat and pressure test every component to its limits. These flaps serve a critical function that goes beyond mere aesthetics. They are essential for orienting and stabilizing Starship, expertly navigating it through the atmosphere with precision in preparation for the final landing maneuver. Should any flaws or inefficiencies emerge during testing, SpaceX must engage in further iterations, making the necessary adjustments to the design to ensure that the flaps can withstand the demands of operational flight and achieve the pinpoint accuracy so essential for Mechazilla capture. The engines serve as a critical pivot to Starship's success, presenting significant opportunities for improvement. The Raptor engines that propel the spacecraft are an example of contemporary engineering prowess. However, they are not without vulnerabilities. The catastrophic failure during Flight 7, which abruptly ended S-33's journey, underscored the importance of propulsion reliability to the mission as a whole. Every phase of the flight, from acceleration to orbit and deceleration to re-entry to careful navigation and the final landing burn, depends on the flawless performance of these engines. A single error or malfunction at a crucial moment could spell disaster, completely undoing months of careful preparation. SpaceX is well aware of this reality, and its engineers are diligently engaged in improving the Raptor's robustness. The goal is clear: to ensure that the engine can withstand the rigors of spaceflight and the relentless stresses associated with landing, while maintaining consistent performance under the most extreme conditions. In addition to the spacecraft, ground infrastructure plays a critical role in the Mechazilla capture effort. Full attention is being paid to Tower B, which is anticipated to be the site of this momentous achievement. Construction on the tower has come to fruition, with the initial segment of the sump, a mechanical arm engineered to capture Starship mid-flight, now successfully installed. Other elements of the orbital launch mount, OLM, have also emerged, laying a solid foundation for the operation. The sump serves as a critical element of the system, entrusted with a balletic maneuver that demands perfect timing and seamless coordination with Starship's descent. To pull it off successfully, meticulous attention to detail is essential. The landing pins that anchor the spacecraft, the guide rails that ensure proper alignment, and the actuators that energize the arms must all integrate seamlessly with the Starship's capture points. In addition to mechanical considerations, it is critical that the tower's communications network be hardened to prevent potential disruptions, similar to the incident that necessitated the abort during Flight 6. Facilitating seamless real-time data transmission between the spacecraft and ground personnel, the journey ahead is underscored by critical test flights, each serving as a significant step toward the Mechazilla milestone. These missions go beyond mere training. They present opportunities to iron out any remaining issues and validate the system in a real-world environment. SpaceX has a variety of goals to accomplish, including successful payload deployment to orbit, controlled re-entry that maintains the integrity of the spacecraft, and a smooth landing facilitated by the latest V2 enhancements. At the same time, it's critical to build on previous successes, such as the precise landing of the Super Heavy booster and the effective reignition of the Raptor engine in the vacuum of space, honing these accomplishments until they become instinctive. The crowning achievement lies in perfecting Starship's controlled vertical landing, a critical component that precedes any serious attempt to capture the Mechazilla. Imagine the scenario: a gleaming Starship descends gracefully from the sky, its engines roaring as it slows to a hover, finally landing gently in the welcoming embrace of a tower. It's a vision that seems tantalizingly far-reaching, yet each test flight serves as a poignant reminder of the intricacies at play. With each launch, SpaceX inches closer to this pivotal moment, building on its successes while integrating insights gained from previous setbacks. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one. Thank you for your support.